I build something?
Well, my name is Jeff. I have three kids, two boys and a girl. My wife and my kids are my life. They're awesome.
So, like, we're on OW. I'm going to school, though. I definitely would love to get a job, but schooling's more important right now.
Like, I've grew up in the city where there's jobs everywhere. No, there's nothing anywhere. It's all on who you know or your education. That's all it is.
You just gotta think about what comes first and just make sure that everything, your priorities come first rather than fun and games come first. They have to come last.
Like, we're on a fixed income, so much goes towards rent, and then you got so much to play with for your phone bill or groceries or diapers or formula.
I think that my telephone and my cable, that's a luxury item. I'd like to try and get out and do things, so we try and find something that's free.
There is five of us in our family. We have this one, Isaac, and two other little girls, Jessica and Mara, as well as myself and my boyfriend, and we live in a two-bedroom apartment instead of a three because it's a little bit too costly for us. And so we've taken our two-bedroom apartment and turned it into a three-bedroom apartment. It is, we use our dining room as our bedroom, which we've closed off. And we're a pretty tight family. Sometimes I can be a little emotional because I get stressed out that I can't work and go to school and maintain the kids all at the same time. That can be a little difficult month to month, so.
I'm gonna get you.
Financially, what helps me the most is my boyfriend. His job, some months, is really good. It can be decent because he works really hard, like all day, like anywhere from 10 to 12 hours a day, he's working 5 days a week. So he does his best there, he helps a lot. The amount of help the community actually has to offer when you look for it is intense. Milk for Mom coupons, they gave me dinner stuff, they gave me snacks for the kids, diapers, everything I needed. And the health unit weighed my kids, helped me keep them on par, came here to make sure I was well because I went through a bit of depression. They were awesome. So that would be pretty much who helped me emotionally. That was my emotional support, my community support.
Vroom.
I know that I'm a great person and that the people around me are all great people and they love me and respect me for who I am, not what I make, you know, not where I am financially or how much I own. I have an awesomely big soul and I think that that's what makes me who I am, not my finances.
Oh, thank you. Very nice.
When I was a kid, my parents had very, very good intentions. They definitely wanted us to have access to the best that there was, so they fought very hard to put us into good schools and good areas, which was very good in many ways. The flip side is then you are like the only poor kid in that entire school. So, I mean, definitely I noticed at a pretty young age that, you know, there was a difference and there was a barrier between the lifestyle that I had and some of the lifestyles of my peers. My kids are still very young, so I don't think that they've quite reached the age yet that they or their peers can really identify the differences. And because I grew up very poor, I mean, you know, I'm very sensitive to making sure that those differences aren't very apparent with my kids. So, I mean, I don't think that they necessarily acknowledge a struggle. It does it makes it very difficult for me because, you know, it's constantly juggling and balancing and, I mean, for lack of a better term, keeping up appearances. And there's definitely a lot of stigma that are attached to being poor, so you definitely have to be careful of what people see when they look at you, because people jump to conclusions that because you don't have very much money, you must be lazy. And sorry, I need a minute. So once I knew that I was about to be a mom and I was going to be responsible for providing a lifestyle for my kids, I just wasn't okay with the possibility that I might have to tell my son that there isn't enough food. And that was a huge inspiration for me. I knew I had to do something. I had an eighth grade education when I became pregnant with my son, and I knew that wasn't going to get me very far. The job market, even for people who are educated, is very slim. So definitely being somebody without even a high school made me almost unemployable. So I did what I had to. I enrolled in school, I applied for government funding, I relocated my family, and we had quite a bit of struggles. We toughed it out. I had to send my kids to their father, and I had to sleep in my car for a few months. And it certainly wasn't easy, but there was a light at the end of the tunnel, so we just kept on going. And I mean, now it feels so good to be able to buy or to cash a paycheck and take my kids grocery shopping. And it sounds like such a simple thing to do, but to be able to let him decide what he wants to have for dinner and then go home and make it for him, that's enough. Sorry.